is a really big book. I think maybe about that thick my copy is. That thin if you're reading it on Kindle. So what was the state of the project when you came on board, and where was your kind of starting point?
Well, I think there had been many versions of trying to adapt this huge book, as you say, into a screenplay. Most of them done in Hollywood, and they often call it the book that's not adaptable, you know, the book that's unfilmable. And I think it is, in such some respects, it is unfilmable. It would be impossible to make a book and do it any credit to turn that book into, you know, a two-hour film. But for us, we were looking at making it into a six-part television series at the time. So therefore, we had this greater canvas, and it meant that we could do the book justice within that sort of time frame. One of the things that we focused on, what is the opening of the episode and what is the closing of the episode, what is the climax of the episode? And we did do some very big and bold moves of narrative from how it appears in the book to how we present it in the television series, and where the climax of episode 3 happens in our series, that actually happens a lot later in the book. We brought it forward because it felt right. The same with the Battle of Waterloo. We always thought that that might have been the climax for episode 4, but I woke up at one point and suddenly realized that Waterloo wasn't a climax of an episode, it was actually the beginning of an episode. Nothing actually gets resolved in Waterloo. It's about what Waterloo does to our lead character. And so therefore I realized that we had to move it from the end of episode 4 to the beginning of episode 5. And that's this sort of big, energetic and action-filled opening. And then the episode is actually a very much more kind of personal sort of journey, a much more personal drama for the rest of the episode, a much quieter episode, but a very strong one.
I suppose episode 5 is kind of all about death in a way, and what it means to Johnathan Strange. He doesn't actually kill anyone in the book though, but he does in the opening of episode 5.
Well, I think he does kill somebody in the book, in the way that we show it actually, but it's a man on a horse. And it's described in the book that he pulls the soul out of this man and then crushes that man's soul. And so I guess it's debatable whether or not the man dies, but my impression was that he does kill a man at Waterloo, and I wanted to emphasize that and make it categorical that that's what occurred, because it was something he said he would never do. Wellington says, could a magician kill a man by magic? And he answers,
I suppose a magician might, but a gentleman never could.
And so therefore his values were such that he wouldn't kill a man, but in Waterloo we wanted him forced to the point that he is forced into killing somebody, and the reverberations of that for his character was what I was interested in, and that's what I think. And you're absolutely right, 5 is very themed around death and grief.